I am 26 years old and the cult of Jawa specifically is older than me. Today I am riding a It is a Jawa, but it's not the regular Jawa. It is the Jawa 42. Well, the pause you saw in between, that is the expression you get when you see the Jawa and the 42 together. The difference is not much, but it is specific. Today, let's find out what are the differences. If we talk about the styling, the Jawa 42 resembles the Jawa standard or the classic, we can say, in a lot of possible ways. For example, it gets the same teardrop design for the tank, similar design for the seat as well, covered telescopic forks, suspension and all the hanging parts. Well, they resemble the Jawa and the Jawa 42 very well. Actually, for a fact check, Jawa and the Jawa 42 share these cycle parts. The list of differences include that the headlight unit is now completely different, but it still gets a round headlight. The handlebar is different and the motorcycle gets a matte paint job. Rest of the styling aspect, including the Jawa tag all over the bike, well, it's at the exact same places as the Jawa standard. However, the 42 looks a little bit more modern, and that's the reason I like the 42 more than the Jawa standard. One of the differences that a layman would miss is that the fender over here is different. This mudguard is smaller than the Jawa standard. While the Jawa standard gets only 3 color options, this one gets almost 6 color options. Although the design differences are very minor, this motorcycle does get that attention like a Jawa. There are lots of bits that are finished in chrome, but the Jawa 42 gets a few bits that are finished in matte black, like the handlebar, and it does look pretty good. If I talk about the switchgear, the Jawa and the Jawa 42 share the same units. The quality feels nice and it is easily accessible to the thumb. Even the levers are the same and it feels good to hold. The bar end weights are finished in black and so is this console. This cluster displays the same information that we have seen on the Jawa standard. Yet, this one is better because you can actually read those numbers. It is positioned in such a manner, unlike the one on the Jawa standard, which was on the headlight unit itself. It has a backlit which makes it easy to read in the night, while the black finish makes it easy to read in the day as well. Talking about the electronics, the Jawa 42 is not different from the Jawa. It gets no LEDs whatsoever. The ergonomic triangle is exactly the same as the Jawa standard. The 765mm seat height is easily accessible. The foot peg is at the same position. The handlebar is not too wide. It feels just about right for the Jawa 42. Adding to that, the mirrors are also placed a little bit outside so that you can actually see what's behind. The seat cushioning is just as hard as the Jawa standard, and there's not much space for the pillion too. Pillion does not even get a grab rail. There are these grab handles which come below the seat. So if you notice, this Jawa is standing on a main stand. The Jawa standard, the test bike that we had earlier, did not have one. Talking about the performance, the Jawa 42 uses the same 293cc single cylinder engine. It produces 27 bhp of power and 28 Nm of torque. The torque curve is pretty linear and it gets a very good low end and a decent mid range too. Well, it has the same characteristics and it lacks top end as well. The throttle response is exactly the same and it does not feel as choppy. The FI unit does work well. In a similar condition as the Jawa standard, even with the Jawa 42, vibrations kick in after a certain point in time if you're pushing the motorcycle. So if you go anywhere above 80 to 85 km per hour, the vibrations will creep in from the seat, foot pegs and even the handlebars. It gets the same 14 litre fuel tank and you can expect a similar mileage close to 35 km per litre. So you have the same range from the Jawa standard or the Jawa 42. The exhaust note is also similar and you can change between 3 options, while there's no harshness as such. The 6-speed gearbox is actually slick shifting, but the clutch feels exactly the same. It is slightly heavy. Unlike the older Jawas, the Jawa standard and the 42 get a radiator and the fan dissipates heat pretty nicely. There is nothing blocking the engine, hence the heat is dissipated a little further from the legs. In stop-go traffic, the heavy clutch will definitely bother you, not the heating. The Jawa 42 uses the same double cradle frame as the Jawa standard. It keeps things in control even if you are pushing the motorcycle. As I mentioned earlier, this Jawa 42 shares its cycle parts with the Jawa standard. The telescopic suspension at the front has the same 135mm travel, while the dual suspension at the rear have a small 100mm travel. Even at the medium setting, the rear suspension feels a little hard as compared to the front one. which means that the rear suspension is adjustable, the front is not. It gets the same smaller wheelbase, so tipping into corners is quite confident, but then the bigger handlebar makes it stable too. It holds the line better than the Jawa standard. The tires are also the same. It gets an 18-inch at the front and a 17 at the rear. These tires are same tubeless tires with tube in it because of the spoke rims. Another major difference as compared to the Jawa standard we rode earlier, this specific motorcycle gets dual channel ABS and the braking feedback has gotten even better. The front brake still lacks the initial bite, but the feedback increases as you brake harder. The pedal feel for the rear brake is a little dead, but it feels better than the drum brake option. Coming to the verdict, should you consider buying a Jawa? Only if you want to get yourself a classic retro motorcycle. The Jawa standard that we rode last time and the Jawa 42 over here, these are the production models and they feel much better than the pre-production ones that we rode quite some time back. If you want to get yourself such a motorcycle, then you should definitely consider the Jawa 42 because it comes at a slightly easier cost. If you want to get the proper cult ready Jawa standard, it will come at a slightly higher cost. But then this one with the dual channel ABS variant will cost just as much as a single channel ABS Jawa standard. So the choice is up to you. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, do hit the like button. And if you have any comments, do let us know in the comment section below. Thank you. Bye-bye.